5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We heard learned counsel for the parties on 29-8-2011. In some writ petitions, the allottees, builders who received the allotment letter by the Greater Noida and Noida hereinafter referred to as authority were impleaded, and several applications for impleadment were filed by various allottees, builders. We, after hearing learned counsel for the parties by our order dated 29-8-2011, allowed learned counsel for the state, learned counsel for the authority and other parties to file their affidavits. Insofar as the applications for impleadment and interventions which were filed by various applicants following order were passed on 29-8-2011. After hearing learned counsel for the parties, we are of the view that the applicants, namely allottees, builders, shall be heard by this court under Chapter 22, Rule 5A of the High Court Rules without being formally impleaded to the writ petition. Various applications were filed for intervention along with affidavits which were taken on record, and we heard learned counsel for the petitioners, learned counsel for the estate, learned counsel for the authority and learned counsel for the interveners. The hearing was completed on 30-9-2011. Along with the main writ petition, there are writ petitions challenging various similar notifications issued under Section 4, read with Section 17-1 and 17-4, and Section 6 regarding 41 villages of Greater Noida and 24 villages of Noida. In main writ petition, counter affidavits, supplementary counter affidavits have been filed both by the state as well as by the authority. Counter affidavits by private respondents as well as the intervention applications along with affidavits by several interveners have also been filed. Pleadings being complete in writ petition number 37443 of 2011, the said writ petition is being treated as main writ petition. Insofar as other writ petitions of different villages are concerned, learned chief standing counsel has stated that counter affidavits have been filed by state and authority at least in one writ petition of each village, which may be treated to be leading writ petition of the said village. Although in some other writ petitions, counter affidavits have also been filed by state and authority. The writ petitions relating to different villages are separately grouped, and it shall be suffice to refer to the pleadings of the main writ petition as well as leading writ petitions of each village along with pleadings of some other writ petitions which were referred to by different learned counsel during the course of hearing for deciding this bunch of writ petitions. The fact as brought on record in the main writ petition and the reference to the pleadings in the said writ petition are sufficient to comprehend and decide the various issues which have arisen between the parties in these writ petitions. Hence, facts of the case of the main writ petition and pleadings therein shall be noted in some detail. Writ petition number 37443 of 2011, Gajraj and others versus the state of UP and others have been filed by 27 writ petitioners who claim to be Bhumidar with transferable right and owner of different plots of land situated in village Patwari, Pargana and Tehsil Dadri, district Gautam Buddha Nagar. The notification dated 12-3-2008 was issued by the state government under Section 4(1) of the Land Acquisition Act 1894, notifying that the land mentioned in the schedule is needed for the public purpose, namely for the planned industrial development in Gautam Buddha Nagar through Greater Noida Industrial Development Authority. It is useful to quote a relevant extract of the notification dated 12/3/2008, which is to the following effect.